Well, hello there, everybody, and welcome back to what I like to call the Anthony Bishop Experience here in Madden 19. Getting set for some fun in the rain at home against the LA Rams here in Week 6, and obviously we're on a two-game win streak. We would love to make it a three-game streak against one of the best defenses in football. And of course, our defense has to deal with Goff and Gurley and the rest of those big-time playmakers. Obviously, we've got our hands full trying to get this team to reach their full potential. Bishop has been the main source of production these past couple of weeks. Keenum's done a pretty decent job of avoiding turnovers. Obviously, it hasn't been perfect. And we're going to need him to step up this week against this LA Rams defense. Already down by 7. First drive of the ball game. Case Keenum's first throw to Sanders is dropped. Sanders has been pretty unreliable this year through the air. Here's second down. Keenum out to Bishop right side. Trying to spin past two defenders. Can't get there. But his first touch comes through the air. Can we move the chains on third down? Keenum from the pocket. Good time to throw. Looking wide open over the middle. There's Demaryius Thomas. And we're across midfield. Someone outside number 28 needs to make plays through the air for this offense. Keenum from the gun. Hands off left side. Bishop's first run. Kept to 3 yards. There's Mark Barron. So obviously, if you guys can't tell, if you don't follow me on Twitter, I had mentioned that I was probably moving the series over the postcom. And I think that's what we're going to stick with for the foreseeable future as Jeff Heuerman picks up the first down. I just feel like I haven't found that groove yet with the live commentary, and it feels like it's kind of dragging. That's just my opinion. I'm not sure what you guys think, but I want this to be entertaining for me and for you guys. So we're going to keep this experiment going for the next couple of games. So this first drive is going well, but here goes a run up the middle. That's not going to be the game plan for most of this week. So no gain on first down. Keenum sacked on second down as Bishop's taken off the field. Back on the field for 3rd and 17. And look who's open. Why would you take him off the field? Anthony Bishop with the hands. 1st and goal from the 8. Look at this route. Joyner thinks he's going to the flat. Absolutely not. We're going right up the seam. Thomas clear a lane. 1st down, Denver. Not bad. 3 tight end look on 1st and goal from the 8-yard line. Freeman checks in. Keenum's got time, good protection up front, rolls around, throws a strike to the end zone for Jeff Heuerman. 1st of the season. Up to this point, it had only been Bishop and Sanders with receiving touchdowns. Now it's Heuerman in the end zone. So our first drive not too shabby. What about the second? Defense got to stop this time around as Bishop picks up 7. There's the best run of the ball game as Wilson and Donald are there to make the play. High formation, toss right side. Bishop trying to get in space, and he made one defender miss, but couldn't get past Mark Barron again. 3rd and 1. Do the Broncos trust the ground game here? Bishop led by Janovich, who didn't do a great job there on Barwin, but Bishop does muscle head for the first from the 30. Now is Keenum to the air. He's got time. Out to the flat for Bishop, who's open again. Did you read the scouting report to midfield again? This offense looks good. 3rd reception already of the ball game, and the Broncos are putting together quite the drive, and Bishop showing off. Now we've got the ball deep in Denver territory from their 27. Here's Keenum. Quick throw. Jake Butt, 1st down again. Keenum, 10 of 11. 123 plus a score. The ground game, not too shabby. Here's a double A gap blitz bluff from the Rams as Keenum throws right side and picked off. No. Nickell Roby Coleman. Keenum trying to find Sanders, and why are you throwing that? We were in field goal range. You ruined a chance for points, but it doesn't matter because our defense got to stop. Defense came to play this second quarter. Here it goes, Bishop with a rare chance for a punt return. We do not get many of these because normally we're just backed up, and if they're punting from their own 40, 35-yard line, it goes in the end zone. So got a nice 10-yard return there. Here's 1st and 10 for Denver, trying to run it up the middle, and Dominican Sue able to bring down Bishop as he's got an 8-4-21 start, which is not the greatest. Ball in midfield, just shy of the 2-minute mark, and here goes another run for Bishop, and he makes the move. He gets across the 40 and down to the 33 as Donald could have possibly saved the touchdown. This is where you gotta watch out for number 28's ability to make you miss in the open field, because whoop! Look at that, making Joyner trip on his own man. That's pretty impressive. Ball now at the 29-yard line. Keenum from the gun again. Here goes pressure. Keenum throws over the middle for Sutton. That was close. Mark Barron in the area, but that's going to be a reception. Minute 34 to go now. Keenum looking outside. This is nearly picked off again by Mikel Roby Coleman, that hit him right in the chest. Caught a break on first down here. Second down, Keenum. People open over the middle, but tries to find Thomas and nearly picked off by Peters. Make the right throw, please. Third and 10, Sanders in motion. Keenum moving out to the flat. Keenum over the middle this time for his tight end, Jeff Heirman. Thank you for making the right read. And now it's first and goal from the six. Three receivers. Bishop stays in the block. Keenum steps right, throws over the middle. He's got Sutton. Touchdown, Denver again. That's two scores for the Broncos to begin this ball game, and neither have gone the Bishop. Interesting. I mean, obviously, he wants to score too, but as long as we've got the lead, it's all good. It's football, baby. We got the lead. And then our defense gets a turnover. This is where things might get interesting. Here's Keenum throwing and missing. Sutton was open. You got to hit him in stride. Could have been a big play to get us in field goal range. Now second down. Keenum under pressure and doesn't get it off in time. Taken down by Aaron Donald. First time of the ball game here. It's third and 16 from the 48. Keenum, he's got time. Looks up the seam. This is nearly intercepted. We should have just run the ball down. We got a little too greedy. First half in the books, and the Broncos start with the ball here in the third quarter, looking for some more points, and we're going with the run. Opposite side of the blitz. This is getting a little too predictable as Bishop gets his ball to just shy in midfield. The game plan is if we see a safety roll down, we're running the football the opposite way of the blitz. It's going to be man coverage. Our receivers should be able to win these matchups outside, and that's exactly what Courtland Sutton does. Look at number 14. Sutton's making plays through the air and in the run game. And Bishop, another nice move in the open field. Got to keep this momentum going as Keenum throws to Jeff Heirman, and there's a first down again. Little quick out route to get us down to the 26-yard line. Jeff Heirman now five grabs, 54 yards from the 26. Keenum looking again for Heirman, this time working right side. Heirman inside the 10, down to the 8-yard line. They can't stop 28. They can't stop 82. There must be something here with these numbers. Just put Mark Barron on an island, and he had too many responsibilities there to cover and couldn't get it done. So it's goal to go for the Broncos from the 8. Here's a give to Royce Freeman down to the 2-yard line, and Mark Barron shaking up. Bishop back in the game. Janovich moving left to right. Broncos run it right side, and Bishop gets around the edge for his first score of the ball game, and the Broncos now lead by 2 scores. This is honestly one of those rare opportunities. This offense normally doesn't play with this kind of lead, and our defense keeps it a 2-score game after the Rams add 3 points. So 21-10, here's Keenum rolling right side, takes off the run. Bishop trying to throw a block, but can't get the Sioux in time, and Keenum picks up 3. Not much time left in the third quarter. Here's a give to Bishop up the middle. Nice run there to the 40, good for 5, and here's 3rd down and 3. Broncos need to move the chains here. 28 seconds to go. Keenum quick throw and nearly picked off. For some reason, completely missed Jeff Heirman, who was wide open in the flat right side. But our defense finds another stop here in the fourth quarter, still up by 11. And Bishop's run picks up another Denver first down. 5.5 yards a carry almost. This is not too shabby, especially against this defense. Here's a play fake on first down, and Bishop can't get to Donald in time. Not like that's his fault to begin with. This line needs to play better. There's an 8-yard loss on the sack. Backed up to our own 41. Blitz again from the Rams. Keenum outside. This is caught by Sutton. That'll get us back to our original line of scrimmage, but obviously we need to get a first down here. 5:34 to go. Keenum clean pocket, and he completely missed Sutton. So the offense goes 3 and out, and the defense gives up the touchdown plus the 2-point try. 3rd and 4 with 2 minutes left as Bishop somehow missed the first 2 plays. How is your star player off the field for 1st and 2nd down in a situation like that when you need to run the football? No excuse. So now the Broncos give it back to the Rams. They're already up to midfield. This is not good. Minute 18 to go. Here's a catch for Robert Woods up to the 39. 1st and 10. Todd Gurley goes 39 yards through the air. Where is our defense? Down by 4 points, 53 seconds on the clock. Bishop at least on the field for first down this time around as Cam throws outside. He's got Sutton. First down, Broncos. We needed that play bad. Keenum, great job stepping up there, buying time in. There's a nice clean route to number 14, the rookie Courtland Sutton, but we got to get this ball down the field and in the end zone in a hurry. First down, Keenum up the seam for Jeff Heuerman. Another catch for 82. Up to the 40, 42 seconds on the clock. Still two timeouts to work with. Broncos from the 23. Keenum over the middle to Sutton once again. Down to the 18. There's 5 yards, but we need to get this ball in the end zone in a hurry. Hurrying back to the line. Second down, Keenum throws. Thomas with the grab. That's not going to move the chains. Third and one, we call our second timeout. This is one of those situations you would love to catch a defense off guard with a run. As they completely bail out the middle of the field, and there's Cortland Sutton down to the 4, and the Broncos call another timeout. They've got none on the clock, and for some reason, in the most crucial situation of the game, Bishop is taken off the field, and we only get 2 yards, and the game's over. We lost. We lost because Coach wouldn't let Bishop have his Kobe moment. That's ridiculous. Why is Coach such a hater? What play call did we call to only pick up 2 yards when we needed 4 for a touchdown? It wasn't a run. It wasn't a run. It was a pass to Cortland Sutton for 2 yards. That's unreal. And that 17-yard play that Bishop wasn't on the field, apparently he was because he caught a 17-yard pass. So I don't know what it is with this game and simulation, but if Bishop was on the field, there's no reason why I shouldn't have had control of him in that situation, because that 17-yard completion could have turned into a touchdown. Overall, stat-wise for Bishop, not a bad game. 80 on the ground, 60 through the air, pretty average numbers for him throughout these past couple of weeks. Defense played well, but obviously we gave up that 39-yard catch and run to Todd Gurley, which shouldn't have happened, but it did. Jared Goff, 279, 3 scores. Gurley, 16 carries, 88 yards, and through the air, Gurley led the team with 110. What are you going to do? Todd Gurley's a beast, apparently. This was one of our better games on third down. 7 of 12, 58%. This could have been a really great win. We could have won 3 straight, but unfortunately, we're back to 500. We're 3-3, and we're back on the road as we're taking on the Arizona Cardinals in Week 7 from University of Phoenix Stadium. They're 2-4. This is kind of our interesting stretch of the season. We've got the Cardinals, Chiefs, Texans bye week, then the Chargers, who are actually playing pretty well this year. 4-game win streak. Right now, kind of hard to tell who the better team in the division is. Obviously, we have not been very consistent. We could do without the turnovers and hopefully finding a way to not throw multiple interceptions to Patrick Peterson this upcoming game. But that, guys, will do it for this episode of the Anthony Bishop Career Mode. This is one of those games that we're going to look back on later in the season when we're missing the playoffs by one game and say, you know what? Bishop should have had the ball. Thank you guys for tuning in. Hope you enjoyed. Let me know what you guys think between postcom and livecom. Catch you later.